Okay, welcome back to Paddy's Golf Tips. Today we're going to talk a little bit about the wrist action.
The winner of the gold medal and the champion golfer of the year is Padraig Harrington.
Generally, going through all my swings, all my tips, you'll find that there's two parts of what I think about the golf swing. There's the athletic swing, where you've got to move the same as you moved all the way throughout your life when you played sport. When you're swinging a golf club or any stick, you use the same muscles in the same sequence, okay? So we'll talk about that, but today we're going to talk about the second part, which is knowing where the face is. So you've got to have an athletic swing, and then you have to have face control. Face control is very much about how your wrists work during the golf swing. So we're going to talk about those wrists today. Now, again, we're going to probably break this into two parts. The first part is more for the weekend warrior, somebody who's playing once a week. I feel you've kind of been conned into thinking that this is about swinging, turning your shoulders and using your body, where in actual fact, 70% of your speed and your face control comes from how well you use your wrists. Okay, so we want to get a very active wrist. Yes, if you become a very powerful player down the road and you're carrying the ball 300 yards, yes, maybe we'll take a little bit of the wrist action out, but you still need to have the control of the wrist. But if you're only carrying the ball 200 yards, 220 in the air, you need to get your wrist very active. It gives you face control so you can hit fades and draws, and it also adds, as I said, about 70% of your speed comes from how those wrists work in the golf swing. So how are we going to get the wrists active? We want to get them very active to start off with, and then we can decide after that whether we're going to calm them down. Mostly for the weekend warrior, just we want to get them. I've done a couple of things here. First of all, you've got to have a good grip. I've said that all along. A good grip is all in the fingers. I've put a little skills training aid here, which helps me make sure there's a little barrier here so the thumb has to go there and there, which really helps. This is a $20 training aid, maybe $15. You know, get it. It's pretty simple. All in your fingers, and then the thumbs go on top. You've got to have a good grip so that you can move it around, okay? I can move that around with light pressure. There's not a huge amount of pressure with what I'm doing here, and yet the club is not going to come out of my hands. If you feel like you have to strangle the club, hold it tightly, your grip isn't right, okay? You should just hold it naturally, like you would have picked up any stick as a kid. You'd never strangle hold it. So get it in the fingers. You'll know you have a good grip if you can move it in all directions, okay? That's very important. If necessary, sit in front of the TV and practice your grip, moving it all around. Okay, now the wrist action. We want to get an active wrist, so we want to get the club kind of flipping, is what you're going to think about. Now, that's a dangerous word for people who play golf. They think flip, oh my God, I'm going to hit it all over the place. Well, the reality is somebody who feels like the club is flipping, what's happened is they've tried not to use their wrists, they've got probably out of position, and then they flip the wrists. Whereas if you get to your top of your backswing and you actively try and get your wrists moving, they won't overwork, they actually work properly. So there is a difference between using your wrists all the way in the downswing, which is okay, compared to somebody who doesn't use them and then has a late flip. Look, we can see we're live here. This is one take, Harrington. I do these things straight off. There's no second take. So we want to get the wrists active. So essentially, you need a narrow stance. If you go wide, your body gets more involved. You need a narrow stance. So start off with a narrow stance and just try and hit a very firm long chip. So the idea is only use your wrists. You will find that you'll use your wrists and arms a little bit. So just a firm chip. I've just chipped that out there. It's probably gone 80 yards. And I'm going to keep extending that, like so. So now that's a little flick, a firmer flick, maybe 110 yards, and then I'm going to extend it. Plenty of movement in my feet, plenty of movement in my wrists, and I'm just hitting that long chip. Okay, a little heavy there, not to worry. And I'm building up. Now I'm going to get very aggressive. I'm going to try and hit this as far as I can. Heavy, but it's really getting those wrists, really getting them active, getting them flipping, getting them moving, getting them as fast as you can. We want our wrists to be active in the golf swing. When we go and play, we can forget about this, okay? But first of all, you gotta get them moving. Narrow stance, long chip. That's gone as far as my normal 9-iron. That's gone out there 150 yards. So you can see from a shot, it doesn't require, especially on most of your shots from like 150, it doesn't require a big action to hit a shot 150 yards. Most times it just requires a nonchalant little flick down the road there and it will just do the job. Okay, so once we've got those active wrists, plenty of shots like that. You've seen me do this drill before. Again, this will get the wrists. You can line up 5 or 6 balls or more in a row and just flip them down there. Just walk in and get those wrists really firing into it, okay? Now, that's the wrist active, okay? Now I said the second part, well, there's two parts to this bit. Now we want face control. So we always want an athletic swing. So when you're coming from any other sport, whether it's baseball or tennis, the golf swing should feel the same. But you need face control. And that's why we need good wrists. So we've got a good grip. So now we've got to understand face control. So when we're flipping the wrists in here, we're going to do two motions, two exaggerated motions. We're going to flip under, which will cause us to hit a high cut. So we understand the face is too open. And then the opposite, we're going to go a little bit to the right and flip over the top, like we're hitting a topspin shot in tennis. We're going to come over the top. Now you watch, if I flip under, like a cut shot in table tennis, say, where you're slicing it, I'm going to get, the club face is going to work. It's going to work from strong, but it's going to come in and go under. Now I'm learning to add loft. Would I use that in the golf course? Rarely, unless I was going over a big tree. What I would use in the golf course is I'd still be going left, but I wouldn't flip it up so much, but I'd be moving that way, still a little under, and that would give me a normal fade with a 9-iron. But I want to exaggerate it here. So I start off, I get one ball, start in a normal position. Okay, so again, I've hit that nice big high cut. I'm getting used to flipping the club under. Every second shot, I'm going to go the opposite. Or maybe you could do 10 that way, 10 this way. But eventually you should do every second shot. And I'm going to aim a little right, and now I'm going to flip the club down. I'm going to try and hit the biggest low hook I can. Beautiful draw there, just beautiful release. So I'm practicing two moves. One is flip it under, high cut. Two, flip it across over the top. These are exaggerated. You'd only be using this extreme motion if you were going around something on the golf course, but you need to be able to get to that position. You've got to understand what face control is by exaggerating the two moves. And let's face it, if you swung 100 shots with a high cut and 100, the next, say you did 200 balls, one a cut, one a draw, one a cut, one a draw. The 201st ball is probably going to come out in the middle straight. If you've hit 100 big cuts and 100 big draws, the 200th shot or 201st shot will probably be a straight shot, because it's not going to be, it's going to be in between. So that's really it. Get lots of wrist action. Once you've got the wrists really firing, then fire them under for a fade and over. So the right hand is over the top to hit that low draw. You've got to think the club is coming in this way. I'm going to hit it low, low with a big draw. Whereas this one, the club is coming in under like that. And just learn where the club face is. So fast wrists, learn where the club face is. And you'll actually start using this in the golf course. You'll use it for chip shots, pitch shots, and it will just help you instinctively know where your club face is on your longer shots as well. And this is going to, the actual wrist action firing is going to add some speed. What more do you want in the golf swing? A bit of speed and a bit of face control, you'll be golden.